Okay, it is time for Down on the Corner. Nobody ever knows the real words to this song. If you looked them up, you would never believe what it actually says. Anybody who is a CCR fan, you might know half of them. I'm a CCR fan, and I knew about 80%. I couldn't believe some of the stuff that was actually in here when I went to look some of these up. Had to sing this one night, so I went ahead and printed out the words, and it's like, that's what it says? I had the chorus right. But nobody usually even gets that. Anyway, this song is the one, I mean, you can't miss it. It's just the one, as soon as you hear this, bring a nickel, tap your feet, man. It's just the... You love it. Other guitar player in the back just going. Okay, so it's got all this going on, so we'll get both parts. There they are, so do we need to do any more? Okay, so anyway, the main part that you guys want, of course, is at the beginning. This is in the key of C. C, F, and G are the three chords in this thing. So on the A string, third fret, that's right, there's your C. Okay. With your pinky or with your ring finger. I'll do it with the ring finger now. So, third fret, fifth fret on your E, third fret, E. So, twice. Okay, almost twice. First time is, second time is, okay, two times here, then fifth fret on your E, so you have this. Then, so which is twice on your third fret on your E, fifth fret, and then twice more on your third fret on your A string. So that's, if you know how it sounds, it'll be easy. Okay, so listen to it a million times. Then you do it again. Next one is exactly the same, but you drop it down one string. Okay? Which is our only different note. So you do the same thing. Okay, so you actually drop to the fifth fret of the D string. So it's exactly like what you'd start off with. Okay, so first time, very slow. Okay, so you just do it that one twice, then back to the beginning. And that's it. It does it through almost the entire song. One guitar player does that through the whole song, and that is your solo too. When the solo time comes up, just to make it easy on you, when it goes... When it hits that note, hit that same fifth fret with your D string and G string, just flatten out that finger a little bit, because it's just kind of a little harmony thing. Okay, so... Then... what I'm talking about. You've heard it. It just does it the one time, but it's very crucial that you do that. Okay, so that is the one guitar that goes throughout the song. They're all downstrokes. Drop it down. Then. Okay, so that is it. Okay, the other guitar, and I'll go through all these again. And we're nowhere near done, trust me. Okay, it's time for you to get funky. If you're born without soul, you're not going to be able to do this. Okay, da-da-da-da. Down, up, down, up, down. Okay, down, up, down, up, down. Five strokes. Down, up, down, up. Okay, down, up, down, up, down. Click. Up, 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 down. Okay, so it's down, up, down, up, down. Click. Up, 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 down. Okay? One more time. Down, up, down, up, down. Click. Up, 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 down. Okay? That's the last part. Up, up. Down, up, down, up, down. Up, 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 down. Down, up, down, up, down. Click. Up, 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 down. Down, up, down, up, down. Click. Up, 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 down. Okay, then. Okay, that's it to the whole song for the rhythm. Just about silver time. So that is how that goes. Maybe a lot of you didn't know it was quite that funky, but it is. Okay, if you're wondering what kind of chords I'm playing, okay, that probably would help because they're not playing the regular chords, okay? C is just going to be your first finger at the fifth fret, covering the D, G, and B string. You're going to kind of use your thumb to shut up your low E and your A string. So you've got it there. You're not pushing down. You're just shutting them up, muting them, okay? So it's, and I'm using kind of like my pinky like this to actually kind of touch the edge of the high E string, so I can go, if I want to, I can just add it in. You know, but otherwise, I'm using it just to make it muted, so. So anything you can do to just only hit those three strings, your D, G, and B string. The best thing you can always do is anchor your hand somewhere and only let your wrist do the talking here. So therefore, it's only just picking within those three strings. It's not going... I mean, that's just wrong when it comes to guitar playing. I know you see people doing it, but they grew up playing wrong. So if you play like that, shame on you. You know, call me up, I'll come over and shoot you. You should not play like this. That's why they put the pick guards on here, for people like y'all who do that. I do not have a scratch on a single one of my guitars because I play like this. If your pick ever makes a mark on your guitar, ever, you're playing your guitar wrong. Okay? Plain and simple. That's the way it is, no matter what you're playing. If you're just a rhythm player all the time, your pick should never put a mark on your guitar. There's no reason for a pick guard, okay? You can spank you like your mama used to do. Yeah, my mama. Yeah, your mama. Okay, so anyway, if you're playing like that and you're getting marks on your guitar, getting marks on your pick guard, you are playing wrong. Okay, there we go. Done, said. Okay, so there is your C. Right there at the fifth fret, those three. G. Huh? That's just an F chord moved up two frets. Okay, so F. Just move it forward two frets, that's going to be your G. So C. F. Or G, actually. C. G. Or C, G. I'm going to go to F. All you're doing there is taking your existing, make myself comfortable here, your existing C chord, you're adding your middle finger to the sixth fret of the B string, and your ring finger to the seventh fret of the D string. And now you can play four notes. from your D string all the way down through your E. Okay? You don't want to do it when you're on C because it ends up sounding more like an A minor. Okay, so you got C, G, C, C, G, C, F, C, C, F, G. Okay, so those are the way you're going to play your chords. If I yell out the chords, that's what you're playing. So it's both parts all the way through the whole song. So let's actually get into the song and do both parts again. First part. Now hear how clean the guitar part sounds. So turn your volume down, get rid of a little bit of that crunch that you normally use on your Creedence, a little of that overdrive. You'll find the sweet spot where it sounds just like Fogerty's Les Paul there. So here we go, kiddies. We get eight counts beaten in here. Three, four, then one, two, three, four. Let's just do this part. All the way through it. Keep playing this. We'll do this part first. Now we go to G, F, or C. Okay, now actually when that part comes up, you're still playing the little bass part. Down. So you'll play just like what a bass player would, but you're playing like a wild man. Okay, so check out what that person does on the guitar. Down to the first fret, third fret, G, C, F, C. Okay, so that's what the person who's doing the... Okay, so you just go to the F, C, G, okay, so you just do those. Okay, so that's it. Let's get back a little bit and we'll go and continue with that. F, C, G, C, F, C, G, C. Now. Drop it down. F, C, G, C, F, C, G, C. Now, here's that solo I was talking about. Same as the beginning. When you go to this other one, you add that G string in. Here you go. So you added that G string in. F, C, G, C, F, C, G, C. Now we lay out. See, now we're back in. F, C, G, and it keeps Well, that's it. So there is the part in the middle where the... So, actually a rhythm solo. You never get those anymore. Okay, so now let's cover the other end of it. Okay? So that is it for the one guitar player, but you have to find out which parts you're going to do. If you're going to do both or what. So let's go a little bit through this, but just playing the chords. Coming into F. C. C. G. C. C. G. C. C. G. C. F. C. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. G. C. G. C. G. C. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. G. C. C. G. C. F. C. Stay there. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. Here's us. C. G. F. C. C. Oh, sorry. C. Don't listen to me. G. C. And G and C. F. C. C. And G. C. F. C. G. C. F. G. C. G. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. C. F. C. G. And C. Good thing I don't conduct the London Philharmonic. Holy cow, these people be playing all over the place. Anyway, they're all F's and G's and all that. So we're just playing louder than the track just so you can hear the... Even though it's going... Okay, even though it's changing that quick on down on the corner... It does the exact same rhythm as I showed you at the very beginning. So, so no matter that all the chords are changing, the rhythm part stays the same through the entire song. Never changes. Ever, 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 ever. Did I mention ever? Okay, ever. So play whichever part you want to play. I'm going to play the back of track. And you just play both parts, play one part, play half of some, but however you decide to do it, there's both parts, and both are very important. So if you have another guy in a band that you're in, or jam with somebody, or whatever, there's the two parts. You can play one part and show him the other part, whichever is easiest for the other guy. But you always want to be the star and do the... Because people know that one. Okay, so I'll shut the heck up if you can believe it. And here we go, down in the corner. Here's our backing track. You guys just jam with it. I will shut my guitar off, I swear.
Yep, I'll step a time over by the courthouse.
them penguins got happy feet. I think the grandkids used to sing that, and the penguins got happy feet when that movie came out. Anyway, down on the corner, cool tune. You gotta love it, but like I said, there are two very, 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 very distinct guitar parts if you're the only player in the band. God, love ya. I don't know how you'd figure it out for two people, or one person to play both parts. That'd be tricky, but have to let the drummer get a little sloppy on his hi-hat or something, fill out that rhythm. Anyway, so there you go, down on the corner, and Penguins got happy feet. Gotta love it, gotta love it, gotta love it. No, you don't. No, I gotta love it. I'll shut up. I'll go take a pill.